your woman.
Four, five.
I sure wish that you could see mine.
One, two, three, four, five. Six, seven,
you been talking about your woman.
Three, four, five.
I sure wish that you could see mine.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Every time a little girl starts to love.
Hi, guys. We're here with our latest line dance called the Tap Dance, which is dedicated to the event, the after party, which is in Irvine, California, first weekend of December in 2019. Our good friends Chuck and Meech asked us to choreograph this dance specifically for the event to help them promote and bring together all of the dancers in solo practice. Okay, we're going to run you through the steps. We start with our right foot, and it's sort of like a sailor step variation type thing. We're going to do one, a two, a three, a four. Okay, we'll break that down a little bit further. We step the right foot forward to the diagonal on the one. We're going to hook the left foot on the and then we step the right foot out to the side on the two. Then we're going to step the left foot to the side on the The right foot hooks on the three, and then the left foot steps out, and the right foot in place, four. Now you hear me saying rather than and, because we don't want it to be sixteenths. It's not one and two and three and four. Maybe if we dance it to a contemporary song, but we like to dance this to a swung rhythm. Our favorite song to dance it to is The Way You Make Me Feel by Michael Jackson. So that would feel like one, two, three, four. If we were dancing to Billie Jean by Michael Jackson, then we would do one and two and three and four. So you can interpret the steps to match the music that you're dancing to, okay? We're gonna move on from here. So we've just planted the right foot down on the four. We're gonna bring the left knee in on five and step onto that left foot on six. You see that we stand up with a full chest. We're now gonna sit into our hip as we bring our weight back to our right and then push ourselves back up to the left side as we chest. So there's a little bit of a hip isolation, and then we oppose that with a chest isolation. So that's seven and eight and. Okay, the first eight counts looks like this. Ready and step and step and step in place, knee, knee, hips, chest. Okay, we're going to continue. We're going to kick the right foot across, step onto that right foot, tap the left foot behind, that's one and two. And then I'm going to step back onto my left foot on the and count, kick my right foot forward as I rotate through, and that was the three, and then I cross over on the and four. It's kind of hard to stop in the middle and do that. So let's go over that again. We kick the right foot on one, step down and tap in place on two. We're going to step back as we kick and three, and then ball cross and four. From here, we do a turn on five. I've messed it up, haven't I?
One and two and
three and four and five, six. Okay, so just stand there facing that. All right, guys, showing you the next eight counts. We have just done our hip and chest and. We're gonna kick our right foot across on one, step down on and, tap the two. We're gonna step back on the left foot for and, kick the three, and then we're gonna step down with the right foot as we kick the left foot through and four. You see, we're starting to turn a little bit to our right. Let's go through that again. So we kick one and two and three and four is a kick and sort of launching action into a ball hook. Okay, if we were to set up like a hook, an unwind, that's exactly what we want to do, but we're going to move fluidly into it after our kick and tap. So one and two and three and four and five, and then I'm going to lift the toe of the left foot as I move around the ball of the right, and that will allow me to equalize to a sort of a squared position at the end. And we want to finish more on the diagonal than anywhere else. Our weight will be on our right foot, on the left foot. Fab's got me in check. So what we're going to do here is what we call a hook up. So we're going to pick the right foot up, heel, left foot, heel, and then step in place right and left. So that's and seven and eight. And that concludes the second set of eight counts. Okay, let's go over that. So we finish here. We're gonna kick the right leg on one, step down and two. We're gonna step back as we kick three, step and kick, four, ball hook, and five, unwind, six, right heel, left heel, and seven, and then step in place, and we tap the left foot down on the eight. Okay, so we're gonna move on. From here, the heel's up, okay, and we wanna use that as a point of resistance to pull ourselves into a quarter turn. So we move from our right diagonal, or 1:30 on the clock, and we're gonna shift through and push the knee forward to 10:30. So that's our quarter turn, from diagonal to diagonal. Now we're gonna do something that we call a camel walk, and we're gonna lock the step as well. So we're gonna step off of our left foot as we extend our right. So we go push, step, and we land on quite a flat foot. From there, we're gonna pick the heel of the right foot up as we draw the left foot underneath. You see that pushed my knee out. We're gonna do this once again. I extend off of my left foot as I push to my right. And then I'm gonna step out to my left, four. How have I done it wrong again?
Now this is good, but then it's step, boom, boom, boom.
Okay, it's because this is one, two, three, four. I forgot
five.
To count the one. Yeah.
Where do you wanna go from? Press?
Okay, so we're gonna make a quarter turn from 1:30 to 10:30 as we shift our knee through on one. Then we're gonna do something we call a camel walk. So we're gonna push out of our left foot and land on our right with a bit of a flat foot and a straightish leg. So that's two. We're gonna draw the left foot underneath us as we do the same on the right foot. You see, I pick the heel up. That gives me the opportunity to knock that knee forward. We've got one more step as I extend off of the left on four. Now we're gonna do a grapevine to the left. That was on the diagonal towards 10:30. Now we're gonna grapevine to the left, side, behind, ball cross. And that's heading to the back of the room, which will be six if we start at 12. That would be six. And from here we do a half turn just on the balls of the feet, really. Okay, and that concludes our third set of eight counts. So going over that third set, we just did this and seven and eight. We pull through one, two, three, four, grapevine, five, six, and seven, half turn, eight. Okay, so we're gonna head for home. The last eight counts essentially is a reverse whip variation, okay? So we're gonna step forward on our one, and we're gonna ask for a prep on the two. So we're gonna swivel through our standing leg, our right leg. From here, we start a turn, and then we go into a coaster step, three and four. So that's a turning coaster step. And then from here, we're gonna use the rotational energy that we've built going to the left and send ourselves back to the right on the and count, and then slide out for five, six, seven. And then here, we have an eight and that we want you to actually use to begin the dance. So seven is the end. Then here's the beginning. Eight and one, a two, a three, a four. Okay, so even from the very first rendition, as you count yourself into the music, mm-hmm. We did begin the teach from one. That makes a lot of sense for a lot of people. But you can think about the end and beginning being a transitional area. So the last accent is seven, eight, and one, two, three, four. That's going to have a much stronger connection mm-hmm. to the music and a much better feel yeah. for you, the dancer.
Okay. And when you dance to the Michael Jackson song, The Way You Make Me Feel, we said at the end, there's a hit where there's no instruments at the end. So as you come out of this reverse whip, we can hit straight at five, hold six, hold seven, eight, and one. Yeah, so hearing that in the music, whatever song you're playing to, if the song is silent, if it breaks and everything's quiet, then we stop. Okay, if it doesn't, we can slide out.
In that song, there are three opportunities to hit that break in that way. So listen out for them. Okay, let's take it from the top, run through all 32 beats, then you'll see us dancing it to music. Okay, so here we go, ready? Seven, eight, step one, a two, a three, a four, knee, five, six, seven, eight, kick, one, and two, and three, and four, and five, six, and seven, and eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, and seven, eight, one, prep, three, and four, five, six, seven, eight, and one, a two, a three, a four, five, six, seven, eight, kick and tap and kick and hook, turn heel, heel, full step, knee, step, lock, step, grapevine, ball cross, unwind, step with a prep reverse coaster, step, slide, five, six, seven, eight, and one.
All right, guys, well, here it is, out slow.
You've been talking about your woman.
Four, five,
I sure six, wish that you could
eight,
see mine.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
You've been talking
one,
about your woman.
Three, four, five,
I sure
six,
wish that
seven,
you could see mine.
One, two, three, four, five.
Every time the little girl starts to love him, she brings eyesight to the blind.
Kick and tap and kick and hook, turn, heel, heel, step,
my daddy
swivel,
must have been a
step,
millionaire,
step, side,
cause
side,
I can tell by the way she walk.
Reverse the whip, slide five, six, seven,
but daddy must have been a millionaire, cause I can tell by the way she walk. Every time she starts to love him, to deaf and dumb begin to talk.
Five.